So, you know, I've been using ChatGPT for qualitative data analysis, for thematic analysis and coding specifically. And I do have several videos in which I explain step by step how to use this tool for this purpose. However, you also know that it does require a lot of hand holding and does make a lot of mistakes. There's a lot of trial and error and basically back and forth with this tool. So I decided to improve it a little bit and use the opportunity to build my own custom GPT. Based on ChatGPT, it's just an option they provide to its users since recently. It's only available to GPT Plus users. If you are on that plan, then it means you can explore the different GPTs created by different users, and that's where you can find this qualitative research assistant, which is something I developed. So basically, it's a work in progress, and it still makes mistakes. Don't get me wrong, it makes plenty of mistakes, just like normal GPT, but it is more narrowly focused on qualitative research and data analysis. So I have been feeding it my content, so basically how I explain things, and my blog articles and my video transcripts and all sorts of things. So that it kind of uses similar approaches and explains things in a similar way. Although, of course, it's such a huge topic that it gets things wrong sometimes, very often drifts towards this more general explanation that your normal GPT would provide rather than what I wanted it to say. But in these situations, I encourage you to specify that you're asking how I would explain things, for example, in which case it usually is pretty accurate. It starts using all these comparisons, whether they are actually my comparisons or is trying to imitate my style, but it does tend to try to simplify things for you, so it's a good thing. Another thing that it does a little bit better than normal GPT, if you ask the normal ChatGPT to code your interview transcript, for example, what will happen quite likely is it starts to actually provide lines and lines of code, like programming code, I believe. Whereas if you ask my ChatGPT to code your data, it immediately assumes you're talking about qualitative research and does the coding. Another thing that you can do is ask this ChatGPT to code the data and put the text and the output in a table for you. You do have to, rather than uploading the transcript, in which case it cannot do that request, you do have to paste the transcript into the chat box directly, and what will happen, it will put the transcript in the left-hand side column of the table and codes in the right-hand side column of the table, which is really nice and something I always wanted to have. Even in NVivo, it's not exactly how things are done. So this is a good addition. So as you can see now on the screen, for example, if I asked it how to code qualitative data or how to code data and qualitative research, it does frequently refer to my approaches and basically uses my comparisons when I explain, for example, that coding is basically breaking things down into small segments. It's literally what I say in my videos. So then it breaks the process down into the three stages as I usually explain them. So it doesn't go, although it tends to go through these, as I said, other approaches. Sometimes it will often refer to Brown and Clark's approach because it's such a well-known approach. But sometimes it does kind of remember to use the approach I usually use and how I explain things when I talk about these three key stages. You can see, you can watch that in this video. You can see the link on your screen now where I break it down into this. Now you can see there is a whole bunch of practical tips as well, most of them actually based on what I said. You can ask it all kinds of difficult questions related to qualitative research. I've also been uploading whatever I can in terms of PDFs and important knowledge. So difficult questions such as the sample size in qualitative research. So it's doing a pretty decent job as well. However, I wonder how it would explain it, trying to explain it the way I do, because I do have a specific method in mind and specific blog article in mind where I explained and broke it down this difficult decision into a couple of different strategies. So I'm asking it how I would answer this question. So whenever in doubt, just you can ask this this question, and that's where it's going towards where I want it to go, and it's exactly how I talked about it when I talked about saturation. I do have a blog article about it, and I explained that that's the kind of approach, that's the kind of term you want to bring up if you're justifying your sample size. So that's about it. Remember, it's a work in progress, like I said, and it's still ChatGPT, so I'm not developing a completely new tool. So I am limited by its, I guess, capabilities. However, I am constantly feeding this tool more and more information, so I would encourage you to use it if you are already a current GPT Plus customer, because you're not going to lose anything by simply using this over the normal ChatGPT. Is going to be at least as good and probably better in many ways. And I would also want to ask you to provide feedback and just comment here, maybe under this video, comment and let me know how you're using it and what it seems to be doing well at and maybe not so well at, so that I can keep feeding it more information and building it and making it even better as a tool for qualitative data analysis. Finally, remember, if you need a more personal and tailored approach and support from an actual human, an actual me rather than my copy, my digital copy, I do offer a whole range of services. Have a look at my website. We can work together. I can help you plan and design your research study, as well as analyze your data or support you in data analysis. So just explore this website for more services.